Quickplay. And to be honest, supposedly I should probably take the Quickplay title off now, because we played through the main story. And now we're going to be going through the stage select, looking at some of the extra missions.
Stage select.
Probably going to start and do them roughly in the order that the story goes through. I'm not going to be looking to S rank them on camera. We're just going to go through and show each level and mission, because each mission does change the layout slightly. Mostly in location of enemies and pickups and stuff like that. But occasionally it can miss an area out. Off my head, I can't think of any that give you access to an extra area, but they will encourage you to explore the areas you previously wouldn't, if that makes sense. So, first level in the hero story was City Escape, so let's go on that. Let's say I'm not going to worry about S ranking. You can see here we can't go on the third, fourth, and last mission until we have done all the previous missions. So, best time, that you know, the default time, 30 minutes to beat. I think we can beat that just about as Sonic. I'm going to try and keep with it a little bit and try and push through these fairly quickly. But some of them are a little bit more difficult and require a little bit more sort of exploration time than others. So let's jump into this one. It's the same on every level. Each mission will be pretty much the same principle. I don't recall what order they're in, but I think there's like a... I think the first one is going to be collect so many rings. I suppose we'll find out in a second. If this decides to load. I think Sonic's died, guys. Did this to me the other day though on the Chow World. It just sat there and it looked like it wasn't going to load, and then when I was just about to open Task Manager and give up on it, it loaded. Okay, I guess that's going to be one of those moments then. I do have a lot of junk running in the background, to be fair. Okay, let's try that one more time. Failed to start game. Have I missed an instance of it? Kind of find this a little bit annoying sometimes. Yeah, because it has SA2 battle.exe. It also has launcher.exe. And then it's going to upset my start menu because, I mean, you guys don't really see this because it only videos the window, but usually when I start this, it moves the start menu from my second monitor to along the top of my first monitor. This is really weird how... Although it didn't do it that time. Maybe that's a good sign that it's going to behave today. But at least, you know, we don't have to wait too long. We can get straight back in and load up the second level. There we go, City Escape. Stage 1, collect 100 rings. And this was Sonic, this is easy. Almost all of the early levels when I did this the first time round, I was getting an extra life from the collecting plenty of rings, so this should be a snap. I mean, I am missing a lot, but still. A little bit rusty, I'll... So we're up to 46 already and I've missed half of them. I think is there one in under here? Oh no, that's a little animal. Set me free. This is one of my favourite Sonic levels, just the soundtrack. I really love the soundtrack in this game. Let's just see. Now we have power-ups. collect a ton of rings and save some time. And we can also bounce onto the rails to get a speed boost. If you bounce onto a downhill part of the rail, and this should do it. What? Oh, come on, that's bullshit. That's twice that bit that's bugged out on me, and twice I've done it. I'm starting to think that, this part of the level is maybe a little bit twitchy in the PC version. Now I'm going to go for the chow crate up there. Partly I'm just exploring to sort of re-familiarise myself with the levels, because there are a lot of places where you get ring containers hidden, but it's just been so long I just don't really remember. This should do it. There we go, 107. I believe the rank in this is based purely on how fast you do it, so pretty much the only way to get... You know, I keep talking about S rank, I can't even remember if this game goes up to S or it's just A. Anyway, your highest rank is based on how fast you do it in this, so you're pretty much just going to collect every ring on the snowboarding section, and then you're all good. Okay, we're going to stay in level 1 for the moment. I think we're going to clear 5 of... clear all 5, I think, just to show all the different style of extra missions. So we'll dump these here, find our good chow. Give him some funny ears. And I have to go on a little mission later to find him, like a unicorn and peacocks and shit like that. Make him look ever so pretty. Feed him a skunk, because who wouldn't want to be a skunk? God damn it. Skunk's tail. And now, because of course we're in the stage select, it brings us back out to the chow lobby rather than dropping us back to the main menu or the level run. So, third mission. Again, I don't remember what this is. I think this is to find the chow. Yeah, find the lost chow. So we'll see, as we go along, each sort of mission variant does have slightly different power-up locations, slightly different enemy locations. There are enemies that are the same across all versions of the missions, and the same with power-ups, but it does tend to vary a little bit. Collect the little animal from here, because I know I'm probably going to find a chow key at some point in this level. Go down this way this time, just for the sake of being a little bit different. I don't want to do the same thing every time. Just a little note from these rails. If you can tie, you see how there's a little flat bit at the bottom? Time your jump correctly as you come down, it will pretty much instant transfer you to the rail in front of you. Lets you continue the speed, and you usually get a load of points for doing a stunt. I hate that bit of the level. I really hate that bit of the level. There's no... The reason I hate that bit of the level is because Sonic was one of the first games I ever looked at, even looked at with any interest in speedrunning at, and that bit of the level is the bit that I turn away from watching people speedrun this game, because there is, on speedrun.com, where all the sort of big where you see a lot of the speedrunners go, there is no glitchless speedrun in this game. And that really disappointed me, because if you're going to abuse a glitch to win to finish a game faster just for a speedrun, that's fine, because you're competing with other people who are doing it speedrun-wise. But I like to play games to experience their content. So even when I started looking at doing a speedrun, I was looking with the intent that I'm going to do it glitchless. And with some games, that does exist, but with other games, not so much.
Try whistling here. There must be someone here.
Now we start to see where a lot of the little furry animals are hidden.
Ouch!
Yeah, that was careless. Kind of committed. Once you press the whistle button, you're gonna wait for the animation to display. Let's go up here. I'm starting to think maybe the chow on this level is right here. I'm really glad that's kept me a power up there, because I really don't want to have to keep risking using my rings. Not that big a deal on this level, but it's not something we want to do. Okay, I'm going to drop off of this now. Because of those steel crates there. And magic gloves. Change to magic hand in the action window. Press B button when an enemy is close. Capture enemies when they turn into a ball. Try throwing the other enemies. Basically just a way to get some points and kill an enemy. It's not really that practical. There are not a lot of situations where you'll want to use it. Okay, so, again, because this is a chow mission, we're sort of forced to explore a little. So I'm just taking the time on this mission to sort of move around and check all the little hidden things that we don't normally see. That was a mistake. Screwed by the camera again. Okay. That's better. Right, so this little guy here, this is where he is. So we need...
Yes!
This is kind of why we don't get the ability to do this until we finish the game. You need the Mystic Melody to find this guy in this level. I don't know if that's true of all levels, but you need the Mystic Melody to find him. And that's in the last level for Sonic. Be nice if we got the option to keep them. I'd really love to hang on to all the chows we're rescuing. I know there's some people out there who'd be like, screw it, we don't need them. We don't need chows, they're fine. It'd be a nice way to, would have been a nice touch to the game if they'd have made it so you can get chows with maybe a unique cosmetic or something like that. Perhaps if they'd ever done a Sonic Adventure 3, that would have been the case, but sadly the Sonic games moved in a slightly different direction after Sonic Adventure 2. As far as many people are concerned, we didn't get a Sonic game for many years. Because a lot of people, Sonic 06 didn't exist. And I don't know what people are getting at. I mean, the game was buggy, yeah, it had lots of issues, and fact that Amy just stood there and let the princess let Snogs on it, it's just... It's like, what the fuck, dude? But it wasn't that bad a game. Yeah, it was buggy as hell, but... I mean, this has hardly got really slick controls. Okay, on to the fourth mission. Reach the goal within 3 minutes 30 seconds. So this is basically a speed play mission. Now with these, it does help if we hit the tricks because they tend to give us a little bit of a speed boost. And if we don't hit cars and stuff, that's going to shave stuff off our time. Getting better at just hitting those corners properly. Run up the wall, but it's faster. Ignore the enemy. We're gonna go straight from here. This is how the speedrunners really should be doing this. No bullshit, I'm gonna like back up here and glitch onto this here. It's just, it feels wrong and it's fine to have that in existence, but I don't like it. I'm wasting time here just to get key. Probably not the best way to go about it. I'm gonna try that jump, but you see, we're almost 2/3 of the way through the timer already. I don't need those. Let's not waste time. Onward. I was trying to light dash along those rings. Irritatingly, the bounce and the light dash button are the same goddamn button. Well, this is a fairly short mistake. You notice there's no checkpoints in this because you have to run the whole level all the way in the time. How the speedrunners handle doing this level. I wonder if the glitches work. See, I've not seen anyone do it on the mission, so I wonder if the glitches still work in the mission level. I'm going to ignore all the pickups and so on now. We're not here for points, we are here for speed. Come on, rings, move faster. I saved about 5 seconds off that then at least. Alright, trying to jump me. Too quick for you, boy. Oh god. Nearly. Okay, as long as I don't actually get hit here, this should be a shoo-in. well. Doing this with the electric shield gives you a shitload of rings coming down here. There's quite a lot of rings on this level run, but because you can't see where you're going, you normally miss them all. Okay, we've got time to spare.
Yes.
Awesome. Rank
too
B,
easy.
That's not too bad considering. To really get the good ranks on these, you've really got to learn all the speed tricks, like doing all the rail transfers and stuff like that. It's not insanely difficult to do, but it does take a little bit of practice. Okay, I don't want to dwell too much on the Chao levels. We'll do that at the end. For all those people who just want to watch some Chao racing. Now, the last mission. Let's see what this one is. Hard mode. So, this is basically more enemies, faster enemies, tougher enemies, and I believe some of the trick locations change slightly. Yeah, things to screw you up. And we also get no shield there, which... yeah, extra enemies.
Ouch!
Enemies are faster.
Ouch!
Oh god. And there's gonna be two more here. Yeah, gotcha. The two guys pegged. See, we also get enemies that are from later levels, and we also get, I'm not sure if, you know, so we get stuff that we need the power-ups to clear. I'm not sure if there's actually any instances in this game where, maybe I should have been paying attention to the level. I'm not sure if there's any instances in this game where that there are optional power-ups you need. Yeah. Okay, that's not good, missed that. I think there's a lot more moving cars here as well, and it punishes you more for hitting the cars. Whereas on easy mode, you just sort of plow through cars. This guy's fucking hurt. I'm just gonna blitz past these guys. I do not want to fight. Okay, back to where we were. This little asshole. Oh, I figured I could just bounce with that. I think I need to kill it and back off. And then run up the stairs and jump on sideways. This is one of the things that makes hard mode so awkward, is you get used to... You kind of got used to how forgiving Sonic is in, like, jump distances and shit like that, but then you get to hard mode and there are jumps you just you can't make unless you sort of find the right jumping off point. That's kind of the point of hard mode, I think. It could have been harder, even. I mean, this is nothing insane. This is... I am being punished a little by being careless. I mean, it's not... I'm not dying because the game's massively difficult. And frankly, anything called hard mode should punish you every time you are careless. So there's no excuse for being careless if you're playing on hard mode on anything. If you're playing an easy game, playing casual mode, playing easy, playing a game just for fun, then you have an excuse. You're playing hard mode, no excuse. You should be doing well. Like, minor fuck-ups like that and you're not excusable. See, one of the problems with these ones is before you can sort of jump and hover in the air waiting for them to shoot, these ones you can't because they get a second shot off way too fast. The Chow Crane is moving. Wasn't it on the right there before? Oh well. See that guy? That guy was waiting to ambush me. Hoping I'd just run straight into it. Ouch! See what I mean about a second shot screwing you up? In a lot of it, I think there's also certain bits in the game where there's, in the speed areas with that rail where you'll just push through fast, there's a lot of instances of things where they put extra traps in the way. So you'll just be blitzing along the rail thinking, oh, this is cool, all is well. And then you just randomly die. Like that guy, sitting in the way. If I hit the boosters and not backed off on the throttle, instant death. Okay. So we now have to wait for the enemy to get in exactly the right spot, home and attack to it, and then light dash across. Bearing in mind, if we light dash at the wrong moment, we'll just use the bounce bracelet and go straight into the pit. Any enemy undeaded. Make sure I've at least killed every enemy that might appear in the front. Skip past the ones and I die. And this guy on the right is going to try and hurt me. Not sure, but I think this is faster this time. Basically, if I crash, screw up, don't take a bend, whatever, it's gonna hit me. Level yet, because if I remember rightly, there is some things here. here. Hidden in this area. I don't think it's the second chow key, but... Okay, is it? Oh, it's a sheep. I'm wasting time for a sheep.
Yes!
Okay, just C rank. It. It's not too bad. Not for a first run. Okay, well that's an entire level done. I think we're going to call it there, guys. I'm going to we'll go a little bit into the chow section now. I think that's it for the normal gameplay for now. Although to be honest, I'm probably not going to do a lot of chow today because there's not really a lot of new stuff to show unless I start spending a lot of rings. So guys, if you don't want to watch the chow section, thanks for watching. Appreciate you being here, guys. Thanks a lot. I'll see you all in the next episode. If you want to stick around for the chow section, you are more than welcome. So, I suspect we might just about be tough enough now to do some of the higher level races. So we might have a, I think we're going to have a go at one of the entry level races. Because we've also been feeding him fruit while we're using the dark character. So let's take a look at the next chow race, because we've got the light and dark races now that we've unlocked both cards. If I remember rightly, before we weren't that far behind the dark chow. No, actually, we were racing baby angels with the dark chow. So I think our main problem, if I remember rightly when we did that one, our main problem was stamina, and I fed both these guys stamina up several more levels since then. I still think this is a bit of a stretch, but I thought we can at least try if we know how far out we are. We got a much bigger stamina bar than I used to. I love how the theme changes for this now as well, where we've got the sort of dark trees and stuff. So I've got a lead, but I am burning my stamina really quickly. And also, his stamina bar is going down really fast without me even pressing anything. So I am wondering if I've even got the stamina to make the course. Because his stamina bar empties, his speed is going to go down quite significantly. I'm going to have to hope for his intelligence and so on to carry him through. I hope that he gets lucky and doesn't trip over again. Last time I tried one of these, trip over I think 3, maybe 4 times. I'm going to stamina up one more time. And then I think I'm really pushing it. There's no way I can hit the stamina again. I'm probably going to run out of it. You need ballet lessons. Oh, look at the grin on that guy. That's pretty much it now. Something I really don't like about the mechanics of this, if they're going to make a mechanic where you could fall over and stuff like that, they need to make it common enough that it almost evens out, so that there's luck involved, but it's a little bit of bad luck can't screw you over. Oh, hello, Rmaster034. I'm sorry, I don't speak German. I would if I could. Sadly, I did it at GCSE, and I think I remember about 6 words. I'm so terrible at foreign languages. I'm willing to learn, but I usually go as far as learning I don't speak your language in their language, and then telling them I'm English, and that's pretty much all I can handle. After that, I kind of get stuck. Why? Okay, so let's try one of the... We could try a dual race. These stats. So I think they average out about the same, but... George has such... Shade. I'm guessing that means that you are not happy about the lack of German. Okay, let's try the Aquamarine level 1. Key is swimming. Well, we're fairly balanced in this. Just why that pops up. I'm going to just look something up. I'm not even going to try and pronounce that. I'm too terrible. It's just... Let's just concentrate on actually winning this race. You know, it takes a lot of concentration to hit the A button every now and then. I think my swimming is better than running, so I don't know whether to use that then or... Oh god, these guys are way ahead of me in swimming. Nothing I can do. I am screwed. We need a lot more levels here now. Okay, according to Google Translate, that shade in my chat means damage. I suspect Google Translate may not be entirely accurate on that. Either that or the person who commented that in chat has been seriously damaged by my lack of German speaking. I do honestly hope that is not the case. Oh, we really need to get Fred into some decent training. This is pathetic, Fred. Pathetic. How am I going to get people to bet on you like this? Leicester City had better odds to win the Premiership. Look at all those little celebrating chow. Come on, Fred, burn your stamina. Look how slow he is without stamina, that's pathetic. Well, he was slow anyway, but... What's that saying, a snail's tired? How do you tell? Try again? I don't think so. We need to get the whip out and start cracking it on Fred and George. Let's just try a challenge race as well, because now that we've split all these races into different categories, so they don't get harder as you go up the categories. They start easy in their category and get harder as you go along. So while I don't think we're going to be able to win this one, let's try it, why not? That's what we're here for, right? To play the game. I mean, how boring would it be if we just sit here and farm continuously until all the chow stats are 99 and then we do all the races? That'd be so boring. It just wouldn't be worth doing. Okay, so we've got a little bit of a lead using a bit of a stamina there. Now we come down to the hidden intelligence stat, which I kind of hope Fred was quite quick on. And he falls over again. God damn it, Fred! Every time I try this race, Fred falls over at least twice. Okay, I'm going to make sure he gets a good jump here to save a bit of swimming time. Clearly, we are not going to win this race. I want to do this legit, but I'm just sitting here thinking of how much fruit I'm going to have to feed this chow to level him up. This is why the chow editor exists. Oh yeah, somebody else is falling over. Go Fred, kick him in the back of the heels. There is no need to play fair here, Fred. Kind of find this bit a bit weird, because it doesn't take into account how far through the process you are, it's just the further along the track you are, the more of a winner you are. Go on, get ahead. I'm not having you finish last again. Even though we're almost out of stamp. That's not my chow. I borrowed that chow from someone else. My chow is that silver one at the head of the pack. That gold one, I mean. That gold. You know, you get those parents at sports day that their kid is useless, but they're there anyway because they're good parents and they want to support their child whether they do good or bad. I know how they feel right now. They're like, we tried so hard, but you're still losing! Are they gonna steal all the Sonics before I get there? No! Take the Sonic! Take the Sonic! At least he's... Okay, I am getting the impression that this chow is actually fairly intelligent. It's just... He's clumsy. This chow is me. I mean, I'm always bumping into doors and stuff. I knew that was coming. I knew it! To be fair to the little guy, he does have different feet every time he races. And I don't think he's quite used to the weight of his tail. And he's out of stamina. Come on, Fred! You can do better than this, Fred. You are better than this. Oh, I can't watch. We're going to be a position 8 again. Okay, next Sonic game, all chows are to get a ribbon for finishing. Yeah, because that's generally the trend at the minute. We award participation, not victory. Actually, I'm not going to go down that route. Let's not talk about the greater philosophies of life, the universe and everything, and the philosophies of rewarding participation rather than success. A very long debate for a much more serious channel. We've already damaged a German today, let's not go any further. This is taking so long! Fred, how are you this slow? How is this even possible? He's gonna get eaten by the crab. I mean, they don't look hungry now, but in a couple of hours by the time he's made it across the pool, those crabs are gonna be starving. My money's on us falling down a pit, too. Oh no, we just fall over. There's no pit there, but we just panic as we go past them and fall over. Is that 4 times or is that 5? I lost count. I'm gonna beat my chow for every time he fell over. Maybe that's wrong. Maybe we should use positive reinforcement. I should tell him he's a good child for trying. He tried his best. Yeah, I shouldn't get on the little guy's case. He tried his best. That's all I can ask. Where is the little fucker? Hey there, buddy. Good child. Good child. You tried your best. Tried your best. Oh, shit. I actually didn't mean to do that. That was an accident. The chow abuse was accident. Oh, and there's more power cores here. We could have made him stronger. That could have won us the battle.
Don't worry, buddy.
Okay, don't worry about it. Okay, come on. Come on. Let's take you to school. I will reward your failure with some more time in school. You can learn to draw. Yes, we will leave you here. Let's go and get George too. Because let's face it, it's going to be a little while before I come back here. George!
Don't worry, buddy.
Hey, buddy. My chow are always sleeping and always mad when I wake them up. It's like I can't not wake you up when you're always sleeping. Okay, so we have two chow in there. Learning. Let's see what we've got on the black market. Now that we've played through the missions a little bit more, we should have at least a little bit better ring pool. Yeah, we've got over 1,000 rings now. And we've got a load more emblems, so we should maybe unlock a few more things. Okay, there's nothing massively interesting here. The only really significant thing I'd say is the chow fruit is here. What the chow fruit does, I think this is the one that, it gives you a little bit of all the skills. So it's, if we can get to the point where we can grow that, we can like level up all our chow's skills through fruit. But I mean, let's face it, it's 200 rings, it doesn't raise it that much. I could probably buy a level in everything at the moment, but not a lot more. So it's probably in the next, probably in the near future, we're going to start looking at hatching some more eggs. We're going to get a Sonic Chow, and we're going to get a Tails Chow, and maybe look at see what other colours we can get hold of before I do this. Okay, so I think we're going to call it there, guys. Thank you for watching, especially the guy who was damaged by the experience. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. Bye-bye.